Chaitu's Kitchen. Today we will see one Punjabi dish which is my favorite and I know yours also favorite. It is chole bature, spicy chole served with soft and puffed bhaturas. So come on, let's see how to make it. We'll see the ingredients to make chole. So here I have soaked 2 cups of chole for almost 6 hours, and if you have less time, you can soak it in hot water, or also you can soak it overnight if you have more time. Now here I have 1 large onion puree and 1 medium tomato that is pureed. We have coriander, ginger, garlic, green chili, and we have spices here, cinnamon, cloves and bay leaf. And all other spices are coriander powder, chole masala, little turmeric, red chili powder, salt and cumin seeds, that is jeera. Now we'll start by firstly cooking the choles. We'll pressure cook it for 4 whistles, and while cooking we'll add 1 bay leaf and little of salt, and we'll pressure cook for 4 whistles. See, the chole is cooked properly, almost 4 whistles. See, this way, so soft. Now we'll start making the chole. So now my pan is heated and I have put 2 tablespoons of oil here. Now firstly I'll add cumin seed, jeera, 2 small bay leaf, cinnamon and 2 cloves. Now I will add ginger garlic and green chili. I have 1 green chili and 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. The ginger garlic and the chili is also cooked properly. Now I will add the onion paste and let it cook. Onion is cooking from almost 1 minute. It should cook properly till the rawness goes off or the oil separates. See, now onion paste is cooked properly. Now I'll add all the spices. This is coriander powder, red chili powder, turmeric, and then now I'll add the tomato puree and let it cook properly. Onion and tomato puree is cooking for almost 1 to 2 minutes, and still we have to cook it for almost 1 minute till the oil separates. Now I'll add the chole masala and salt. Salt will add only for the tomato and onion puree, because while cooking the chole we have already added the salt. Now let it cook for around 2 minutes. See, the oil is already separated. Now I'll add the chole with the water and let it simmer. See, we got a proper boil and the chole is cooked properly. Now you can adjust the consistency by adding little water if you need more gravy properly. And at the end, you can add coriander leaves and the chole is done. For making bhatura, here I have 1 cup of maida, that is all-purpose flour. I'll put in the big bowl. 1 tablespoon of curd. And then I have salt as per the taste. Here I have semolina, that is rava, that is 1 tablespoon of semolina, fine semolina. And then here I will add little of baking powder, that is 1/4 teaspoon. You can add 1/4 teaspoon baking powder and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. Now I will add oil in it, 1 tablespoon of oil, and this, by adding little water, I will make a semi-soft dough. I will add little water and make a semi-soft dough. The dough is little sticky now. Just we have to knead it for 7 to 8 minutes, and then we have to rest it for 1 hour. Okay, so after 1 hour, we will see the dough. We'll check it. Okay. Now we will start making the baturas. Okay, so now we'll start making the baturas. We'll just roll out it, and you don't have to put dry flour. You just, if you want, you can apply little oil, and don't make it too thin or too thick. Okay, you can make it the size you like, and then see this way you have to see the thickness. You can see. And now we will put it in the hot oil. Okay, the oil is hot. We'll put the baturas. See, it has to be puffed a little bit. And then we have to fry it from both the sides. See, it's like a balloon.